Hey everyone, welcome back to another exciting episode of Breaking the Ceiling. Today I have somebody very special with me, somebody I have known for many years, but unfortunately we had never met face to face. This is the first time meeting her face to face, which is awesome. She is somebody who started a new revolution around organic products. In my personal life, I've been using her products now almost for a decade. She's none other than the MD and founder of Nourish Organics, Seema Jindal. Seema, welcome to Breaking the Ceiling.
Thank you so much, Ashwini. So good to be here with you. We love Equinox. We trust Equinox. So it's really nice to be doing this with you. And yes.
Seema, I have been a consumer of your products right from back in the day. Personally, then when my kids were born, they love your products and they always keep looking forward to it. It's such a healthy alternative to so much junk out there, right? So your product almost have now a fact following. But before we dive into Nourish, this show is all about getting to know the entrepreneur behind the brand. So tell me a little bit about yourself before Nourish Organic.
So I went through some personal journey, and around 40 years of age, I decided to completely change my life, get into fitness, get into outdoors, mountaineering, trekking, running marathons. I'd never done any of that. I was purely a yoga and, a little bit of tennis kind of a person. But then I just embraced the outdoors. And, I just love natural eating. I got a lot into eating naturally. And that's when I discovered and, was introduced to all the organic stuff and all the goodies that is already available in India. So personally, every time I went abroad, my mecca was the Whole Foods or... I used to just go there and get bags full of goodies from there.
So what was the aha moment? Like, when did you say, I need to start this. This is something I want to do. What happened? How did you kind of come around that?
So I think the starting journey was when I wanted to lose weight in a healthy way after having my daughter, which is my second child. And going on a crash diet was... like making me really weak and all that. So I started to experiment a little bit. But then we had two very close family members who got cancer. And I was discussing with the nutritionists about what are the kind of foods to give them. And they could really consume very little. So that's when I got introduced to superfoods. That little tiny storehouses of goodness, which would give them a lot of benefit, like even sesame seed or chia seeds or amaranth for that matter. And I realized that, wow, there is so much goodness and it's all there in the ancient way or the way the rural consumer is already still eating. Like if you go in the hills, amaranth is a staple there. It's not like a fancy thing here. And so I discovered that there were a lot of these grains which were indigenous to India. I love quinoa personally, but amaranth is as good as quinoa. So I got introduced to a whole lot of that because I put in a lot of research that time. And I said if it's good and... Another thing that I got to know is how bad sugar was for cancer. So, when I realized that sugar was, causing, was feeding the cancer and causes so many imbalances in the system and the insulin resistance and this and that, and the growing number of diabetes in our country, I just decided that I had to, bring down my palate of sweetness, So the level of sweetness that I liked earlier, I needed to bring that down. And that led me to create things with, dates, with figs, with dehydrated mangoes, and a dehydrated banana. And I got introduced to a dehydrator and I got into raw foods. And when I did that, I felt amazing. I felt like health benefits and... Then I did a nutritionist course, and it just, you know, it was like diving deep into this subject, and I just kept loving it, and everything was being experimented on myself, and my kids took on to it, and other family members, then friends started asking me for it, and soon they were saying, can you make this for me, and I'm traveling, can you make this, I don't want to eat junk. And then, you know, these friends sat me down and said, why don't you do this as a business, you know? I said, really? You know, and I just started like that.
That is awesome. It's just, you know, so interesting how businesses start, right? Something that can become big, started in like somebody's kitchen, started in somebody's living room, started in somebody's garage, right? And they become very large businesses. They start becoming a source of inspiration for so many others. Right. So tell me about the name. Like, tell me the story behind the name. Like, how did Nourish Organic come about?
I think, you know, one of the things that when the Nourish Organic, when I was experimenting with all the foods and all, I was also opening a yoga studio, and I was going to run a healthy cafe there, and which was a very new concept, a raw food cafe, which would serve, you know, fresh smoothies, fresh juices, and, you know, these dehydrated kind of snacks and all that. And, you know, so the whole concept was nourish your body, nourish your mind, nourish your soul, you know, and that was the concept. And then I was using organic ingredients. So it just became Nourish Organics. And we just said, yeah, we like this, you know, and we started with Nourish Organics. And the tagline used to be healthy eating for urban living, because in to my mind, the real rural India does eat healthy, you know, not the modernized rural, which is now taking on all the junk from the cities, but and especially the hills, you know, where they are, you know, getting the fresh produce and everything. So healthy eating for urban living also meant that our products were easy on the go. You know, you could just carry, you know, a whole jar of seeds in your briefcase. You can keep one on your desk in the office, munch on it when you feel hungry. And we always make mistakes, you know, the food mistakes, like eating a samosa or chips or something fried, because we are really hungry and our mind can't think correctly at that moment. So, you know, it's very important to snack in the right way, which gives you, you know, the right satiation till the time you can get the right kind of food. You know, so seeds, I really believe in healthy fats. And healthy fats, I mean, now everybody knows about keto and wants to talk about keto. But I have believed in healthy fats for the longest time, and have been eating healthy fats, you know.
That's amazing. And I can relate a lot to it, because before the pandemic, I used to travel 3 hours a day, 1 hour, 15 minutes in the morning to get to office and 1 hour, 45 minutes back. And at any given time, there used to be granola bars or their bar, you know, your bar is in my bag. And anytime I felt like munching, instead of, you know, reaching, going to the cafeteria, picking up a samosa or anything else, I would actually, you know, eat a healthy snack, right? But what I saw this doing is making eating healthy easy, right? You didn't have to make an effort to go do it. It was right there. It was so portable. And most importantly, it was delicious, right? There are so many things which are healthy, but the taste can be a little overbearing. So all your products, I think the underlying tone or feature is they are yummy, they are delicious, and you look forward to eating them. And there's nothing like having a snack which is healthy for you and you look forward to it. So I think that's a win-win-win combination right there. And I feel that that's the secret behind your, you know, brand growing whatever, because people, once they try your product, they will keep buying it. So that's amazing that what you've been doing.
Ashwin, you know, I have to add this. You know, a lot of times when we talk about healthy products which are there in the market, you know, they may be called an oats cookie. But one of the things that we got in, you know, we got people to start doing is reading labels, you know, because people just, read the heading of the thing saying oats cookie healthy, good for your heart and whatever. And luckily now the government's come up with a lot of stringent measures that you can't write this and you can't write that. So when we say oats cookie, our whole cookie is made of oats. It's not like the first ingredient is maida, second ingredient is sugar, and the fifth or sixth ingredient is oats, very little. So we said that whatever we make, we will make it truly healthy. We will make it what really it is. So it's high fiber, it's truly all oats. So you eat one cookie, you feel really full for a long time.
So you are the original, what people now refer to as a clean label, right? Like what you like eat or what you see on the label is what you're getting, and what the claim is what you're getting. So there's a new whole drive in India. I mean, this has been in the world and in US and all for a very long time, which is the whole clean label concept, right? That every ingredient is up there. It's not hidden. It's actually shown. Good, bad, ugly, everything is on the label, right? And I think our products have always followed that methodology right from the beginning. We've helped in a little bit of wherever we could. We've always helped out in that. But I always appreciated that there was nothing hidden. And if it's an oats cookie, it's actually oats, not 2% oats, and calling it oats cookie, because some people end up, misguiding consumers. FSSAI has played a very bad role in guiding consumers the right way as well. So which has been awesome. And so when you started Nourish Organic, what kind of challenges did you face?
I think one of the challenge that came across was that I participated in a lot of exhibitions, my kids' school fairs, Diwali melas, I used to take a stall, and the best thing was that once people tasted it, they wanted to buy it. And if they did not taste it, it was probably they didn't want to kind of experiment. And sometimes, I was in the north, so here we have people who eat chole bhature and all tandoori food, so butter chicken and all. So I would make them taste, they would say, "No, madam, hum to butter chicken hi khayenge." Like, I've had some good laughing moments with them. But having said that, a lot of people, there's a drastic change since last 4 5 years. For 4 5 years, I had a very select clientele, and being in Delhi, I had a huge expat community who buys our product. We were available at the American Commissary, American Embassy Commissary. We were available at the British School. We were also at the French School. So a lot of the expats who are already aware and probably were familiar with the product were already buying our product. A lot of them are still buying our product even after they've gone abroad, even though they are in UK now and they are buying online. But having said that, Bombay, shops like Nature's Basket and Food Hall, that's where a good I mean, all customers are great. We love all customers, but a very discerning customer comes to Food Hall and Nature's Basket, and so we were the right fit for them.
Fantastic. And so what are through this journey, and as an entrepreneur, people go through ups and downs. We discussed some of the challenges. Now tell me some of your proud moments, like during this journey, any proud moments you'd like to share?
So along the journey, one of the first proud moment was when Fab India decided to keep our entire range under their label, but in the Fab India stores. So we are still. It's been almost 8 9 years since that day, and we are still making products for Fab India. And then. There was one time I was just feeling very low about business, and I got a letter from a mother whose child is autistic, and she said that your products are gluten-free, low in sugar, they're excellent for my son, and we all love it. So thank you so much for making Nourish Organic. And I was in tears because I run a school for special needs kids, and it meant so much to me. And then the third proud moment, besides a lot of other smaller proud moments, was getting selected for IndiGo Airlines. And we are doing really well with IndiGo. And during the pandemic, of course, even when the airlines were shut, but post-pandemic, when the flights have started, people are wanting to buy closed and clean and that kind of product. So we are really flying off with IndiGo. So
Flying off with it, nice one.
it's a very proud moment.
That is awesome. I have not, maybe in the last 2 years, or I've not flown IndiGo or not flown anywhere. So maybe I haven't seen those, but I think that's a fantastic market, right? And there actually may be a silver lining to the pandemic in terms of people eating healthier, which is fantastic. People are so much more aware of quality of food. And it being a sterile thing, you can just, it's all sealed. There's nothing, there's no sandwich. Nobody has touched it in their hands right now. So I see a large, large market opening up for this, right? And people who haven't tried it will possibly not try it, because if you have a samosa versus this, people will not choose this. People are going to doubt the samosa which has been kept open or touched by 10 people. So I see a silver lining in this time of calamity, because I am a eternal optimist. So anytime I see a problem, I always see like, okay, what is the silver lining in the problem? And so tell me a little bit about upcoming projects, like upcoming products, anything new that you're trying. I know there are a few new things because we're testing some of those, but can you tell me a little bit more about new products or new lines that you're coming up with?
So over this time, and again, my own age and requirements, and also growing awareness about proteins. So we are coming up with more vegan protein options, and be it bars, cookies, or other snacks. And that is what we are currently. I think in a month's time, we will be launching something new. And I think Nourish Organic is such a important. I mean, it's a way of me communicating, people in communicating to people and encouraging them to choose healthy. And it's a really, there is no amount to actually becoming or choosing, really becoming fanatic about eating healthy. So we are really a midway brand. So we offer you a tastier option and a little switchover, switchover from, let's say you are used to eating brownies. So skip the brownie, have one chocolate cookie, instead. So just small switches which are easier on you, and it's not so difficult to either shed weight or maintain weight, or just generally become, healthier.
So something which I probably have not shared with you, in the last 2 years, I've been prioritizing my health rather than the first, let's say, 14 years of working in Equinox. Every time work was, first, health was last. But over the last 2 years, I've prioritized health and I've lost about 20 kgs. And the indulgence that I have is your cookies, like one every 2 days is my cheat dessert, which I will sneak in to have. And so thank you for that. Because if you can't go cold turkey, right? You just can't be like, I'm not gonna have sweets ever again, I'm not gonna have sugar ever again, I'm not gonna have this. It doesn't work. Like, it will work for a little while, but then people just go crashing back, right? And so that incremental change in behavior has to be, you need to have, it needs to be enjoyable, right? You can't just suddenly go cold turkey and expect it to work. And that transition was made enjoyable by products, so thank you for that. Right. So tell me about three things you would go, if you could go back in time and tell your 20-year-old self three things that you could do differently, or three lessons, life lessons, what would they look like?
There is a lot I'm learning from my daughter. She is very on point, very, she's a millennial. She knows exactly how to go after things and get it. And I think I never did it for money. So I think I was, you know, following my passion. So I took a little longer time, you know, I did not go aggressive in marketing. And I just concentrated on the product, which I don't think is a bad thing. But you know, some focus and money had to be put behind marketing, which I didn't do, and which when we got we had an investment from Sama Capitals, and that's when we you know, pushed it. And because people need to know, if you have a good product, you need to talk about it. You need to let people know about it. By just keeping quiet about it and just being in the market and just being available for sale is not enough. Because you know, where will people find you, and how will people know that there is a product that exists like this? So that is my biggest learning. And along the way, I've learned a lot. I've had lots of you know, great learnings.
Awesome. So tell me about your daughter joining Nikita, right? She joined you about 4 years ago. So how was that? Was that an interesting thing? Was it a natural transition? How did that kind of work out?
So Nikita did her you know, minor in business and major in psychology and you know, photography. And she came to India, and you know, it was literally like you know, when she was studying business, I used to read her notes, and I used to say, oh my God, this is what I need, you know, this is what I need. So I used to pick her notes up, and you know, can I take this page, you know, because I need to read about this. And so when she came, I think she intended to come and just help me out, and she wanted to start her own business, but I think she got completely sucked in, and you know, and then now she's fully handling the marketing and business development, the strategy part of the whole thing, because I think my strength is still in manufacturing, you know, and developing the product. And so she's the brain behind the marketing and the partnerships and the sampling and all the things that need to be done now.
So the mother-daughter duo, that is amazing. So I love when parents and children come together to create something beautiful. It's very rare nowadays, right? Because the new millennial age is like, oh, I will go do something on YouTube, or I'll go do this Instagram thing, or I'll go do this other thing, right? But it's so nice to see parents and kids working together and creating something beautiful and such complementary strengths. Right, and I think I must thank her, saying, "Hey, thanks for making it available right downstairs. I don't order it online anymore. It's just in like in my local grocery store. I can call the guy and he can send it over." Right? So I think that distribution. Then I'm going to thank Nikita for that. So tell me about a superpower as an entrepreneur, as a parent, in your personal professional life. Anything? What is one superpower that most people may not know that you have?
I think the biggest superpower that we miss out on is realizing your own power. You know, realizing how much you know, latent power is there inside you. You know, and when it comes, you know it, when you need it does show up, and you must allow it to show up. And it's, I think every now and then negativity does crop in, and when negativity comes in, it's very important to reach out to the people who believe in you, and who'll you know, bring out that positivity and that strength in you, and tell you that, listen, this is a stage, and this too shall pass. And I think I surround myself with a lot of such people. I have a life coach. I have my daughter Nikita, my son, my very close friend, you know, who also works with me in Nourish Organic, and yeah, I have a very close friend who's a nutritionist, and so she and me, we develop the products together, and Sarika Bansal, and you know, I think they all are my strength. And every time I feel low, they really encourage me. I think my mother really encourages me to stay afloat, and she'll give me examples of how dad was not doing well, or brother was not doing well, and now they're doing well. And yeah, these are all stages in everybody's life.
So most entrepreneurs have this feeling that, you know, we have to be strong all the time and we can't ask for help. If I'm the CEO, if I'm the founder, how can I ask for help? What I normally see is, hey, you're a human. You may be the founder, you may be CEO, whoever, but you're human, you will have ups, you'll have downs. And asking for help is such a critical thing. And many people think it's bad, or people think, oh, how can I ask for help? How will it look? How will it seem? But I feel that's literally a superpower, being able to ask for help. When saying that, hey, I don't understand this, or I can't go through this alone, I need somebody with me, or I need help understanding this, is a superpower. And a lot of entrepreneurs miss out on that. So if you have that as a superpower, that is fantastic. So tell me about mentors in your life, right? Have there been people who helped you? Are you helping somebody? I'm somebody who is completely of the opinion that mentors play a very large role. If you find the right mentors, they can, you know, actually pivot your complete direction. But I would love your take on that. Like, has anyone mentored you? And what do you feel about mentors?
I think mentors are, I mean, you know, people who help you, you know, shape up your destiny. And I just mentioned that I run a school for special needs children. So this was started by Dr. Vasanthi Pai, Mrs. Vasanthi Pai, and she was my mentor in that field, and also to, you know, make me believe in myself and to say that, you know, I can do whatever I set my mind up to doing it. And the second mentor that I miss a lot, I miss Vasanthi Aunty a lot, I really miss Dr. Mona Schwartz. Mona Schwartz was a macrobiologist who believed in eating the macrobiotic way, and she had, she was a proponent of brown rice and proper vegan food and Japanese food. She taught me a lot about nutrition in a very macro sort of a way, and seaweeds and lots of different things. You know, I learned a lot about food from her, and I started Nourish Organic in front of her. So she used to taste the product, she used to tell me about it, she used to tell me the right books to read, and so she was absolutely amazing. And I hope wherever she is, she can watch me doing this and feel happy. And then along the way, whoever has, I mean, I have been the chairperson of Young Fiki Ladies Organization, and in that we had this mentorship program. So I did mentor a young girl. Every now and then, some, you know, smaller brands come up to me and talk to me about the journeys. So wherever possible, I do try and, you know, talk to them about it, help them, and but. As of now, I don't really have somebody who I'm mentoring.
But I'm glad to know that you've done all this. I didn't know all this about you. That is fantastic. Like, I didn't know you were chair of the Fiki Women's Wing. That is fantastic. And so now that you've made this offer, right? So I hope a lot of people watch this video. And if they're smart, they'll take you up on this offer. They'll reach out to me and say, ma'am, can you please mentor us? And no, but I think it's very important as, you know, we grow in life personally and professionally. I feel with the wisdom that we gain, and through a lot of mistakes, of course, that wisdom comes. I feel sometimes the burden or the responsibility to share that with more and more people so that you don't make the same mistakes again, right? The way I put it is life is too short to make your own mistakes. If somebody's made their mistakes and is willing to, you know, share those with you, you should be actively, hungrily looking for that. Like, for example, I have 8 different mentors in my life, personally and professionally. Somebody who helps me PR, somebody who helps me with business, somebody who helps me so many different parts, you know, of life. And many people ask, like, why do you go to them? You know, sometimes maybe 5 minutes in an entire year, but that person will give me clarity for the next 1 year, right? Something that they share with me, a perspective that they share with me. But that is so important, because if I didn't have that perspective, I may not have made the right decisions. I may not have made the right bets. I know things could have gone wrong, but having those people there to guide is such a blessing, right? And whenever possible, I do the same for people around me, in my own company, people in the ecosystem. And I'm glad to know that you're a big believer, and I'm going to come for you to, you know, for some tips as well, right? So I will trouble you in the future also. So tell me about work-life balance, the very elusive thing that entrepreneurs say is the work-life balance. How are you, are you finding it? Are you there? Are you struggling to find it? What is your take on work-life balance?
I think work-life balance is something that you can always just keep striving for, and you can never fully achieve it. I don't think it's something to be achieved. It's something that you can just work towards. So I remember somebody asking me about that. Now my kids are grown up, but my daughter's getting married. So I always say I'm like a juggler. I juggle 4 or 5 different balls at all times. And every now and then one ball will fall, you know, and I get up and, you know, I just pick it up and I start juggling again. And that's what I do. But the one thing that I have learned, that in all of this, my own health, my own fitness, my own mental well-being should not get missed out or should not get disturbed. Every other thing, we are all running after perfection, we are all running after everything should be the perfect way. So by keeping my own fitness and my mental fitness, I regularly do meditation, and I have my workout, my swimming, my tennis, my cycling, my trekking, everything, it's sacrosanct, I must do those things. And everything else, if it's not 100%, so what? If it's 75, it's fine. It's just my mind that wants it 100, and nobody else is going to notice that it's 75. But my own personal well-being, I know that if it's not okay. So that balance is what I really believe in. I'm a Libran, so I'm constantly trying to balance.
Libran too.
Yes. I'm Gandhiji. I'm 2nd October.
You're days away from me. I'm 4th October.
Yay.
Oh, wow. It's awesome. I love Librans. So I think out of all the different things, Librans are the best because they're the most level-headed people, is what I believe.
Totally. I second that.
That is amazing. Tell me about your 5-year plan. What do you want to achieve in the next 5 years as an individual and as an organization?
I've had a really fantastic life, and I love my life even now. And so I really don't have anything to achieve. And I just feel that... Nourish Organic deserves to achieve. My daughter deserves to achieve. All the people who are working in Nourish Organic deserve to achieve. And so I continue to, work with Nourish Organic and till my daughter is ready to completely take over and run the show. And I will always be there to kind of support, but maybe not very actively. I want to maybe slightly take a backseat because I want to trek much more. I want to be more in the mountains. And that's how I see myself in the next 2, 3, 4, 5 years,
That is amazing. But that also puts a lot of pressure on your daughter and big shoes for her to fill in, which is interesting. I'm very sure she's up to the challenge.
Yeah, I think she's got bigger shoes than me already.
She's like... That's awesome. I've not interacted with her. I'm going to schedule a call with her as well. Right. So my last question for the day is there are a lot of people who are entering the food business, every year, and especially in the last 18 months, the number of food companies have almost doubled in the country. What piece of advice would you want to give somebody who's entering the food space?
I think the number one advice I would like to give is be true to what you're doing. Don't follow fads. Don't just do it because it's popular and it's doing well right now, so let's do this. Do it because you're passionate about it. Do it very authentically. What you say on the packet, make sure that's what you are selling. And every business has its challenges. So knowing the challenges, get into it. You know, when we only think of the rosy side, then when we come up with challenges, then we are really taken aback. And, you know, we think it's a very glamorous place to be in. But any business, you know, be it the most glamorous job, be it somebody from Bollywood or Hollywood or whatever, you know, we may think that they have a very glamorous job, but it's a lot of hard work. So be prepared. And if you are ready to, you know, sweat it out, get your hands dirty, then get into whichever field of business. But make sure that your packaging and the food safety and you consult people like Equinox to kind of keep your food safe.
I love that learning. I'm going to highlight that part, like learning life lessons for new people. Consult Equinox. I love that. Thank you for that. So this is the reason I have these calls, and the reason I'm doing this is the audience obviously is going to get benefited by it, but I personally get so much out of this, right? Because every person I've interviewed, I've not learned one thing. I've learned 10 new things, right? It's a new perspective. It's a new way of looking at situations. It's having, you know, a larger perspective on life. I loved how you prioritized your health. You're like, you didn't say one or two things. You're like, I love trekking, swimming, tennis, this. I was like, wow, that's phenomenal. I would want to be there. Like, my 5-year goal, I need to have 5 hobbies, 5 personal things that I can work on, right? And physical activities. Like, for me right now, it's probably just a 30-minute workout and maybe that's it, right? I don't have the time, honestly, to do more. But I would want to be at a point where I have the, you know, time, freedom, where I can go play, maybe tennis, do yoga, do trekking. And I've been always wanting to trek. I literally never had a chance in the last few years. But thank you so much for sharing, you know, so openly with us. And, you know, it was so fantastic to get to know you, see you. We've spoken on the phone so many times, but we never had this before. And now I know you so much better as a person, you know, and I feel so much closer. And what I want to end with is a big vote of thanks to you and Nourish Organics. You guys have been fantastic clients. I'm seeing the brand grow, which is awesome. I'm seeing so many new things coming up. And I want to ensure that you all reach new heights. Anything that I can do personally to help that with that, anything Equinox can do, we're always there to support. And I want to see Nourish Organics now, not just in Nature's Basket here, but I want to see it globally. Right. When if I go to London, if I go to US, I want to see Nourish over there. And I know that, okay, hey, we played this 0.01% role and, you know, we've helped them and we've been there right at the beginning when you guys started. And I think that will be a very, very proud moment for me to see you on International Today. It's already so proud that you guys are right here, like right downstairs in a, you know, shop, you're all right here. I don't no longer have to go to a Nature's Basket to get your products, right? It's the distribution is really increased and I think the awareness is increased. And I think with you at the helm, with Nikita, you know, starting up and now growing the business, I think you are the mother-daughter duo. There's no stopping you. So thank you again for taking out the time and joining us.
Right? Thank you, Ashwin. Great chatting with you.
Same here.
I look forward to meeting you soon. When I come to Bombay, we'll
absolutely. Please do. If your daughter son are with you, please bring them over. I would love for you to host you at my house. I've just got a new place. It's right outside. This is an office right outside in the dining area, at entertaining area where we can even, if you guys are up for it, I would love to actually interview Nikita as well. Right. And she's now, is she co-founder or what is she at? Like, what is her title?
She's the BD head.
Yeah. She's the BD head. Awesome, awesome, awesome. So I would love to chat with her. One way or the other, we'll definitely connect. And thank you so much for being here.
Thank you. Thanks, Ashwin. Bye. Thank you, Equinox, for doing this. Bye.
So guys, that was Seema Jindal from Nourish Organics. Such a wonderful human being. I hope you learned something from her. She shared so openly. She shared about her personal life, professional life. She shared how she's so energetic, how she's thinking of new things and creating new products and bringing the culture of healthy eating, healthy snacking in the country. If you want to get something out of the time you spend watching this video. Write down one or two things that you learned from her and go implement it in your life, and you will become stronger and you will break more ceilings. Thank you so much. See you in the next one.